Is your Android phone secretly scanning your private photos? You didn't install anything, you didn't give permission, and yet it's happening, quietly, in the background. And it's all thanks to an app you've probably never even seen. Let's pull back the curtain on the mysterious Android System SafetyCore, what it's really doing, why it matters, and what you can do about it. Stay with me. Because the part nobody talks about? That's coming up. First, let's take a look to see if this hidden app is even on your phone. So, let's check it. Open your settings. In the search bar, type Android System SafetyCore. If it pops up, tap on it. Now, pause. You won't find it on your home screen. There's no icon. It doesn't even show up in your recent apps. That's by design. If the app appears in your settings, tap into it and head to the permissions section. Can you change anything? On some phones, you'll be able to restrict all permissions. On others, you'll see no options at all, which means it's locked in place. Scroll to the bottom. If there's an uninstall button, that's your only real control. Click it, and it'll be gone. For now. But will it come back? That's the tricky part. We'll get to that in a second. So, what is this thing? Android System SafetyCore is a service from Google. It was introduced in 2024 without much fanfare and without asking for permission. Here's what it does. It scans certain images on your phone, mostly the ones you send or receive through messaging apps like Google Messages.
What's it looking for?
Explicit content, especially content involving minors. If it detects something sensitive, it automatically blurs the image and adds a warning before you even open it. Now here's the good news. SafetyCore does this locally. That means it doesn't upload your images, it doesn't send anything to a cloud server, everything stays on your device. Sounds reassuring, right? But here's where the story takes a turn. You never installed it. You never got a pop-up asking, "Do you want this?" And if you're like most users, you only find out about it when someone explains how to dig through the system settings to even see that it exists. So here's the question. If it's truly designed to help, why hide it? And more importantly, why make it hard to remove? Here's the answer. It's baked into Google Play services. Even if you uninstall it today, it could quietly return the next time your phone updates. That's not a glitch. That's how it was designed. This means that unless you root your phone or use advanced developer tools, you can't fully control whether it stays or goes. And yes, disabling or removing it could mess with how some apps like Google Messages work. So, what now? Look, not everyone wants to jailbreak their device or switch to obscure apps. If you're someone who wants more privacy without nuking your phone, here's what to do. First, restrict permissions in the SafetyCore app if your device allows it. You can also uninstall the app if possible. Just remember, it may reinstall itself in the future. You should also try to use alternative messaging apps like Signal or Telegram, which don't rely on SafetyCore or tie directly into Play services. Another good step is to limit app permissions for messages, photos, and camera when you're not using them. And if you can, turn off automatic updates or set them to manual so you can monitor if SafetyCore comes back. None of this is perfect, but it gives you a level of control Google won't hand you by default. If you're a parent, this tool might sound like a smart safeguard, and it can be. But if you're someone who believes that privacy means choice, not just protection, then SafetyCore crosses a line. Because anytime a tool runs silently in the background, touching your private content without your knowledge, it stops being just helpful. It starts becoming a policy decision you never opted into. Google says it's all for good reasons. But here's the real truth. If a tool can scan sensitive content, even locally, without your say, what else can it do? What's next? That's why awareness matters, because once you know what's happening on your own phone, you get to decide where the boundaries are. So now you know. You know what SafetyCore is, you know where to find it, and you know what it's doing behind the scenes. If you found it on your phone, drop a comment and let others know what model you're using. Some devices handle it differently. And if you want a full guide on how to uninstall it completely or switch to privacy-first messaging apps, let me know down below, because this isn't just about one app. It's about being aware of the tools that live in your pocket. Your photos, your messages, your choice. Thanks for watching, stay safe, and stay sharp.